All right, hello everyone. This is Rojo Doto. We are attempting to. I'm getting some Steam messages. This is kind of funny already. This is our first, the second time, community pubcast. So, what we're doing here is we're trying to bring a little bit of flavor, maybe a little bit of learning, to some average. Maybe above average pub games, trying to select some ones that we think are interesting. I am Walrus, aka Joey. As the name of the channel is Rojo, my co-caster here is Ninjas. Introduce yourself.
My name's Ninjas, my real name, aka Roman. We're just, again, trying to bring you guys some entertainment. We are what you would consider probably mid to high skill Dota players, but all in all, we just love Dota. We want to express that to you guys, help you guys love Dota, and just kind of cast some games here and have some fun and hopefully learn something in the process, so you guys are coming along for the ride.
Yeah, commentary is too serious. So, alright, on the dire side, we thus far have Don't Ask, Don't Tell on the Grievel's Greed Automatic Alchemist. We've got Vengeful Spirit automatically maxing aura, or not maxing, but taking a skill in aura, and we've got the Tidehunter, SKB hashtag, with a vanilla donkey. I think that's a special unlock. I've never seen it before. All right, go ahead with the Radiant side.
All right. We do have a bit of a pause here.
Oh, great. Go ahead with the Radiant introductions while we're waiting.
It's kind of hard to see the names here. On Mirana, we have Bender. See, down here on the Radiant side, we have Jack on the CM. We've got M&M's on the Darkseer. Oddly enough, going the safe lane with CM, which leaves Nobop on the Bounty Hunter. as well as Icy Stars on the Rubick. So looks like Rubick Bounty Hunter going top with the Mirana sold in mid, and as well as the CM, the Darkseer going safe lane. So we'll see how this plays out. Very interesting lane choices, not something you would normally see out of really any of these heroes other than the Mirana mid. So we'll see how this goes for them.
Yeah, and keep in mind, guys, we actually don't pre-screen these games. I do try to find ones that don't appear. I just quickly glance at them, make sure that it's not a 30 and 0 pub stomp. But hopefully close enough to be entertaining for everybody here, and we'll just get a little bit of your average from the outside looking in view of a pub game. So everything progressing pretty well here. I think we have someone. Yep, there we go. Rakna Dini is the next going bot lane, and I believe that does round out our introductions, besides the not even going to try it pudge. So, I will someday learn Russian. Actually, kind of ironic, I thought it was pretty funny to pick out a Russian game right off the bat. There will probably be some banter, as we already saw from the pause. The only thing I know how to say is that CYKA, which is apparently calling someone an idiot. And I've been called that a few times in my short Dota career, so.
Already looking interesting on this bottom lane. We do see the Frostbite pickup from CM, which is pretty normal. Ion Shell from Darkseer, but he does opt to pick up the recipe for the Soul Ring as opposed to any of the components off the bat. So not sure what the reasoning is on that. Maybe just so he doesn't have to crow later, but obviously not going to be able to pick up everything there. So we'll see how that plays out.
Yeah, it takes a little while, but sometimes you do see that when you've got enough regen and you're planning on just getting everything at the secret shop. Pub games, gotta love fighting over the courier, so I'm sure he will be happy when it comes time he's got the money needed. I actually see a couple decent sets. Might as well comment on some of these sets here. We got a pretty fully decked out Rubick in the top lane. None of these other players seem to have much in the way of items. Probably noobs then. Like, items pretty much translate to skill without fail.
We just see the Shuriken of Distant Sands on the back of the Bounty Hunter. They're always a nice little pickup, little rare there.
Yeah, Distant Sands actually kind of, I think it's a decent set when it comes to at least the armor, the Shuriken. A little weird headpiece, I think, when it comes to that one. Yeah, this Vengeful Spear definitely took a lot of damage early. Of course, went for that bossy ring pickup right off the
bat. We do see a Frostbite as well as a Vacuum on the Nyx down bottom, so Darkseer is low as well as Nyx. Nothing really picking up there. Did see some action there, so both teams on the bottom lane looking to kind of pick up something there.
Yeah, expect this Darkseer to probably get away soon and throw a quick salve.
And there is a salve.
Yep, there it is. That does look like if you give yourself just a 2 second, very quick 2 second, and then we'll be back on track. We do actually, we found from our first game that did not record, we're troubleshooting the software, which I've actually been fighting with for about a week. No fault, of course, of the program, unless it was me. This Alchemist getting low top. Our first pub game did not record, which is disappointing for both of us. But as of right now, possibly because I'm encoding and doing a multitasking a bit here on my computer, Ninjas does tend to get 2 or 3 seconds ahead of me after a few minutes at a time. So
I apologize for any psychic casting. You may see me call something slightly before it happens, but hopefully the audio will sync up and be just about there. So we'll try and get that taken care of before our next cast here.
Ninjas, it turns out Ninjas can read minds, but when he doesn't speak Russian, it doesn't matter too much.
Da.
Da. Yet. And we're out of Russian, ladies and gentlemen. So, pretty standard 2-1-2 laning here. Not quite the exciting first blood that we just saw formerly, but we might still have to re-upload that video, so if you guys have the patience to watch more than one of our casts here, I will appreciate it. We will probably upload that game again because it was a lot of fun to watch. We've got action top lane. Two-man concoction. Really a lot of harass going down when it comes to this very low HP Bounty Hunter and Rubick. Both burning salves.
Just a quick comment on the lane setups here as well. With Darkseer CM bottom, CM has the makings, as well as Rubick, of a tremendous tri-lane here. I think what I really would have liked to see, obviously not competitive play here, just the pub, but perhaps the CM, Rubick, as well as Mirana bottom, throwing the Bounty Hunter on the safe lane, or mid lane, I'm sorry, and then Darkseer to farm the long lane, I think may have worked out better as far as this lineup, obviously with the Frostbite as well as the Fade Bolt to the lift for Rubick, pretty much guaranteeing a kill on a squishy hero.
Yeah, I really feel like I've actually possibly seen that CM, Mirana, Rubick tri-lane, or at least two-thirds of it coming from Alliance in the past couple months here. So, like you said, I definitely agree. Kind of a strange way to split up experience. Oh, no, I missed first blood.
And the Toby Award goes to Walsru. We did miss first blood.
What a shame.
Not a knock on Toby at all. I think we'd like to point out Toby Wan is one of our favorite casters of all time. I love listening to him. Tremendous Dota knowledge. Very nice guy, and we love listening to him. So hopefully if he ever decides to slum it a little bit and watch our channel, Toby, we love you.
Yeah. Of course, he would probably be taking a break from, you know, his daily 8 to 10 hours of Dota. Which would be asking a lot. Hey, take a break from your Dota and watch some Dota. But hey, I don't know what it's like to work in a video game. I would
love it. Dire structures are fortified.
So, alright. The Mist First Blood.
Rubick throwing the Fade Bolt on Vengeful Spirit, sticking around the tower with no health. Did not really play out well for her. He just threw the Fade Bolt and got the kill. She was very low.
You know, I wouldn't have looked up there if you weren't about 3 seconds ahead of me, so this is working out.
Looks like I'm going to have to take another brief pause here. So I'm sitting at 46. You know.
Oh, with that hook on the Bounty Hunter. That was just no chance there. Very good hook. More or less, Bounty Hunter, pro strats, not moving. But nonetheless, not taking anything away from the Pudge. That's actually very impressive.
Looks like Pudge is going to find the DD rune here.
Yeah.
Thought about it for a second, he passed it up there.
He did, walk right past it. Frostbite on this Nyx, he's taking a lot of damage. If there's a Darkseer here, we'd be in business. Wow, he is really just going to stand here and auto-attack.
And the Nyx is just going to take it, and he's going to go down.
Oh, it's not a DC. You just don't feel good about yourself when you do that. Very strange play, I'd say. Oh. We might see a little more action here top lane, too. Sentry ward that I missed going down while we were watching bot lane.
While we're in a lull here, I'm sitting at about 43 seconds. Where are you at on that, Wall Street?
47, 48, 49.
Okay, so I'm about a second behind you, so I'll get caught up here just out of the nature of the beast.
However that's working, yeah. We'll try. Maybe we'll try the old live cast one of these days here, but we'll do some Let's Plays too. While we're paused here, we'll just kind of quickly go over our idea for the channel. Roman and I have been into Dota for about a year or so. Came both of us kind of from RPG, fighting game background, StarCraft. Roman a little more on the MMOs than me. I've never really had enough time in them. But that's kind of where we came into Dota. Really appreciated the professional nature of the way Valve has position the game at this point in time. I actually played LoL for the better part of 2 years and thought it was the bee's knees, and then I discovered Dota and LoL. To me, no knocks on anyone, it just felt like a pillow fight compared to the skills there in Dota. So I really, really loved the game and felt like a MOBA experience meant nothing. I felt like I was starting completely over. So how did you get introduced to Dota there, Ninjas?
Well, really, through you. So Wall Street was the first one that got me into Dota. Funny story about that, actually. Originally tried to get me into playing LoL. And again, no offense to any LoL players out there, but I looked at the game and I said, no way, you're insane, and never got into the game. So eventually, Wall Street stumbled upon Dota through friends of friends. Instantly fell in love with the game. I love the depth. I love the amount of mechanics, just the way the heroes interact with each other, the team comp. Just really, just a solidly well-made game that's really fun to watch as well as play. So again, we're trying to expand that to you guys. If you're new to Dota, if you're a Dota veteran, hopefully you guys will enjoy just kind of watching us cast here. We do have some action going up top, so we'll take a break from this here. Looks like VS is going to go down. The concoction goes off on Bounty Hunter. No really follow-up to that, though. Alchemist up there totally by himself.
I'm not 100% sure what that arrow hit. I think there might have been a random creep standing near the forest, but I heard it fly.
So again, getting back into a little bit of background for us. Yes, we both do come from pretty heavy video game backgrounds. Me more so the MMOs as well.
Against the RNG here, she's gonna have a kill. Yep, there it is. Oh, that should just hate to see that kind of thing happen. The Pudge with the complete cleanup here. Very standard bottom build from Pudge, carrying a lot in his stash at the moment.
Does look like he is just going to build the armlet phase boots right off the bracer phase boots right off the bat. Little extra chase, little extra HP. And again, while we have a lull here, back to our channel here. I believe one of the things that Wall Street had suggested at one point was a wives cast. Do you want to go in a little more into that?
That was something that had struck me today. And I realized that there are times when the player base that goes on YouTube to watch more Dota is not usually impressed when it comes to knowledge. Radiant's it comes down to more so humor and the personalities of everyone casting. So what it kind of came to me was we both have wives that pretty much detest the amount of time we spend on this game and have made
or any effort, games
or any games particularly Dota, because it's a life sucker. But when it comes to Dota, we thought it would be fun at some point to upload wives cast. We'll set them on Skype like we've got set up here. Let them describe all what the green dudes are doing, what the red dudes are doing. Maybe we'll set them up for a short game because the attention span may not be there. But if that's something you guys would like, just send us a message, leave a comment on this. If you hate the idea, have any comments about a race or intelligence or anything, this is YouTube, so let it fly.
We are ready for the hate. Bring it on. Fully expecting it.
So we'll see. We're trying to come up with some ideas, but it's really going to come down to what everybody wants to recommend to us. And we just thought that, based on some friends' recommendations, that maybe we had the makings of enough personality to
back to the Dota. We see the Frostbite as well as the Lift in the Wall coming off from Darkseer. Nix. Almost taking Limping. Out Nyx as well as Tidehunter.
Limping. Fadebolt's been on cooldown, unfortunately. Wow. You just let Pudge stand in the middle of two or three of your characters and just you've got no chance. So that really turned around hard for the dark side.
Middle tower, everyone,
Bounty
go,
Hunter
now.
Scouting a bit, low ground. I don't know what he's trying to accomplish. Level one in the Shadow Walk.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
He's not careful. He is going to find Pudge. Rather, Pudge is going to find him. If he gets a good hook again, be able to pretty easily take him out. Dismember is off a cooldown, so.
Yeah, that'll more like.
Ooh, big hit.
Nirvana and Bounty Hunter taking out BS very quickly.
Very good. Very good coordination. Apparently going for the rush on the Battle Fury. So they're wanting to splash some crit damage.
It's either Battle Fury or new meta Lincoln's
towers under attack.
Would be interesting.
Oh, and the arrow coming off from around. A good arrow. They are going to be able to pick up Pudge here unless he denies himself.
It's a track, yo.
Which he did.
Wow. Murana with a good safe leap. Ravage doing big damage to everyone standing around.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
The arrow flies and does not hit anybody. Then the swap to the stun. Very good play by BS here, able to pick up Murana.
So, a lot of action bottom lane. Really no need for us to move the camera at this point. Oh, Bounty.
Bounty almost taken. But he is able to shadow walk and get out of there.
Very close, very close. And Darkseer just decided to go in the jungle after getting sick of split experience with CM. Top lane, Alchemist free farming top. Max Greedle's greedy, hasn't had much reason not to just go straight farming build since he's been left alone with all the mayhem on the bottom lane.
He does have that Midas up and running, so we are going to see a big spike in his income here.
In general, the gold graph is in favor of the Radiant. Thus far, only a measly 2,000. Oh. Big swap, actually, to escape the arrow. Not enough to live, but that actually was not a bad try.
You're dead.
Coming
and that's
from Eventual
a cold,
Spirit, good
hard
awareness.
Fact.
There's too many heroes down here.
You see the missed hook there. They are going in on Pudge here. We see the Ion Shell as well as the Frostbite. Are able to take him down briefly there.
Big kill streak in the ball.
Nyx coming in on the Bounty Hunter. And then a lift from Rubick.
Oh,
Bounty Hunter does get away while Nyx goes down. Good fight awareness. He was able to shadow walk to get out of that last couple of hits there.
Just give yourself about 2 seconds. Just count a full two. And we'll be back together. Oh, we got some smack talk going. So everyone, just to let you know, we don't watch these ahead of time. These are pre-recorded pubs, so we just kind of find by virtue of the scores and the heroes that are used. Oh, Bounty Hunter sticking around too long.
Think of it as cat. And the good arrow by Murana, but VS is going to stun her up. She will be able to leap away. And they
everybody
do take time on the process.
Lane. There's only so much you can do when you're going full 4-on-4. 4-on-5, actually. More so bottom lane.
A good hook by Pudge, but Murana is able to get out of that rot just barely in time.
Oh.
She does go down to the BS screen.
Yeah, kinda like that. This is... Whoa, CM!
Another faint hook by get... Pudge. CM.
There it is. It feels so oh, the carnage. The problem is, leaving Alchemist alone for this long with Hand of Midas. In about, I want to say,
Radiant's top
to 15
tower
minutes.
Is under attack.
He'll be completely unkillable.
He is going to be bad news if they don't do something to stop him.
Actually, let's look back at the gold graph and see how these
Green
things
dude's
are
top thing is about
it is
to get knocked
over.
The
Radiant side, so the Alchemist not swinging the graph itself when it comes to the community gold, about 4,000 there to the Radiant. Experience, on the other hand, near enough to even.
Radiant's top tower is
lots of those going back and forth.
Looks like they are going to try and make something happen here on the Alchemist top. So Murana chasing a little bit. BS coming in for the support though. Does
not
get
the
minus armor as well as
the
start.
Off cooldown. Pick whiff. Yeah.
So Murana does go down top.
Good TP's in for the easy pickoff. They probably felt that the Alchemist was going to be bringing more heat, more than one hero's worth.
The DD Bounty Hunter finds BS in the shop by itself.
Yo, green dudes, something bad is happening.
He does need to shadow walk out of here. There is no vision. Stunned himself.
He's feeling very brave. He really trying to take is. This VS beforehand, and he is going to go down.
Touch way late.
And the concoction on Rubick.
Bottom lamp got more damage coming out here on the Tidehunter. Out in the middle of no man's land. Save the Ravage for next year.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
If the Darkseer can search, he's gonna get this. So
he's got it. Does not need it. He used it anyway.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Close enough.
Real briefly here, why the teams are spread out a little bit. Again, just pointing out this is one of our first casts here, so we do apologize. Still trying to hit our stride as a casting team here. Do occasionally tend to talk over one another, both in casting as well as in real life.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
I think I pointed this out earlier. We've got a bit of a desync, whether it comes down to the coding or what, but occasionally we're going to back ninjas off from time to time. If you call something out before it happens, just roll with it.
It's just my psychic intelligence. It's okay.
And so close to a hook there for Pudge. That would have been good. I don't know if it would have instantly been a kill. I think we'll throw in a few casts where you can watch us play on the inside of some of these matches. Probably attempt to speak Spanish.
Oh, and a nice arrow through the woods by Mirana taking out the Pudge.
Wow, that kind of a strange wall. But you do what you gotta do to get that kill.
Bad dude's top tower gonna fall over.
He just felt that he wanted a friend Pudge to carry around with him. So.
He wanted mud golems,
Dire's
but they weren't
top
playing.
Top tower
playing
is under
ball.
Attack. Why is this so bloody difficult?
Let's take a look and run through these items here. We got Mirana building a Wraithband and Arcane Boots straight off the bat. Oddly enough, kind of a strange build to me. Does pick up the Ogre Club. Looks like she's possibly going into a BKB. Trying to take off the stuns from the Alchemist and the VS and the Nyx as well there. A little bit strange build for Mirana to me. But looks like she's going for the survivability within the fights first.
Yeah, almost, you know, rushing those arcane boots, we got kind of a caster build attack. Going. A little surprised we didn't see the early Aquilo build, but she did want that Ogre Club for a little early game tankiness that she lacks. Bounty's just one man roam. Here, he's so close to his Battle Fury.
The track goes off, swap for the CM. Not really a useful swap in her position. Kind of hurt her a little bit, actually, there, putting her out of position closer to the Radiant side a little bit. So they will pick up the kill as well as the track gold there. Where do you think you're going? Bounty Hunter going, opting for the Battle Fury build. Keeping in mind this is a pup, so.
Oh, yeah. Crystal Maiden. She's trying to head as quickly as possible for that Shadow Blade. Alt build, which works pretty well. You don't have the vision to stop her from doing that alt.
Man,
oh, Pudge, he
tower,
is a brave
go,
guy.
Now.
Nothing's gonna come.
We do
out.
Actually see a Blade of Alacrity picked up on Mirana. Not sure if she's gonna try and build that into Diffusal. If she's actually looking for. I don't see any reason she'd be going for Aghanim, so to have the Ogre Club as well as the Alacrity at the same time. Kind of an odd choice, not really finishing out either of the items that she could be building those into. We are going to see CM go down, as well as a lift from Rubick on the Pudge. Pudge will go down in the meantime. Nick's coming in, maybe looking for some cleanup.
They clearly hate trees.
They hate trees. They really hate trees. Almost as much as Timbersaw, I think.
Shredder.
Acid Spray goes off. Building the concoction. And he's going to stun himself in the air. The good lift from Rubick to stop that from going off. Ravage
that arrow's good.
And the swap. Rubick will go down. They wasted a lot to get him, though. Nick's still chasing Mirana.
Yeah, more or less you've got two fairly high cooldown alts being spent on that. It's arguable if they were necessary, but big pickups for the
Bounty Hunter being a brave man. Either very brave or very stupid fight four people, so he will go down as well.
I got you ahead of me a little bit. I'm running at 16, 17, 18.
22, so.
Yeah, it's about two. I want to say it's about 2 seconds every 5 minutes.
It's a little silly, makes for some funny casting, but we will get that worked out in the meantime here. First couple of casts may be a little bit off here, but we'll get that taken.
It's really strange that we're both watching a full-speed game, but we are VSync a little bit.
I mean, I've got it capped, got the VSync on to keep it at 60 frames, so with the encoding, Wallace shouldn't be too much behind 60 frames, I think, if not at 60 frames. I'm not sure what the real underlying issue is here. Again, maybe some people out there more accustomed to the software, more tech savvy than we are. So if you know of the solution or know what the issue is, feel free to leave us a comment. Let us know what the problem is here.
All right. Pudge. Come on, Pudge.
Taking some tower shots there on the high ground. Oh, close arrow as well.
I do appreciate all the skill shots going on in this game. That does make it fun to watch.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Nyx is slowly making his way to that Dagon. Has not picked enough gold to really make that happen. We actually have enough gold, I do believe. There it is, for the AC on Alchemist. Coming up soon, it's going to be working the old slap chop.
Oh, and that arrow was not right on track, but just not enough range.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. That is the typical Morana build, is not to max up the arrow right away. But she did. Still came up short. Big AoE from this Crystal Maiden, but she is in no man's land.
That's a twofer.
Wow.
Nix.
Gotta love it.
The Darkseer blinks in. He wants to chase this, so he does vacuum. Still has the Ion Shell out, trying to get some extra damage, but
he needed to surge way earlier here.
Amazing, Alex will get away from that. Close arrow, was a little bit blind there, just slightly off track, but still a good try for Morana at least.
Oh, Dagon did finish that. Dagon finished the Nyx, in other news. It's just starting to see a bit of a swing here on Dire's side. The result is
oh, and picks. A great arrow from Morana behind the tower. No follow-up though, really. We do see a lift from Rubick. Vacuum. Oh, and the vacuum from Darkseer may be able.
Yeah, that was the strangest lift I've ever seen in my life.
It's a very short lift.
Yeah.
Stun from Nyx, as well as some tower shots, adding some damage onto the Darkseer. Then Vendetta. He has surged though, so he is going to be able to get away from this.
Yeah, pretty close. Did not use the Dagon the second time. It really would be enough.
Ooh.
That also was close. Actually, with the care pace up and seeing that arrow, I would have probably walked into it.
Yo, green dudes, something bad is happening.
At least that's my story.
And he's sticking to it.
Alright, Alchemist, back to more of this PvE style play. Yeah, more or less, we are seeing the big swing going right now to XP on the Dire side. Gold still staying about the same. Oh, big picks on Rubick. Not getting away at this point.
We do see Alchemist working on that Maelstrom. He has the Gloves of Haste. I'm assuming he's going to try to build that into a Mjolnir here. Really building up the gold very quickly. That Midas, as well as Max Grievel's Greed, putting him up to about 1800 right now. So he's going to be able to finish up that Mjolnir fairly quickly if he continues his farm.
It is downright silly. The amount of gold he gets in the jungle by himself.
Yo, good guys. Middle tower got owned. What you
going on? Ron ulti. Frostbite on Pudge. They're looking to make something happen. That arrow went straight through Pudge. Not sure if that was a glitch or what really happened there, but
also appreciate the midair 180.
And then he's able to deny himself off as well. So we've got an Invis Tidehunter coming in for a Ravage, most likely.
No.
Wait. He waited for it.
Wow.
Is able to pick up the CM, as well as Alchemist being able to pick up the Darkseer as well. So
it was just kind of a leisurely team fight for them. I felt like they just couldn't be bothered to fully commit, and then they just came in and went, "We're gonna win this team fight."
Really taking a long time to make up his mind about that Ravage, only catching two people out of it. But they did pick up both kills. So
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Things starting to look very good for this Alchemist. Got his Maelstrom picked up. Got the Iron Branch, most importantly.
just a real quick peek over to the EXP as well as the gold graph, as you were saying, Wall Street, once he picked up that that Midas, it was going to swing heavily, and it has. We see at that about 20-minute mark, just a straight dip from the Radiant side over to the Dire, to almost 2,500 advantage for the Dire now, as well as the EXP shifting heavily, almost about, looks like about 9,000, just about.
Uh-oh, can he throw it? Can he? He will throw it. And Slapchop. Get out. Oh, his ult's off. His ult's off. No, no.
Bounty is able to pick up that kill. Nick's throwing stun. They're going to be able to pick up Bounty here, though, unless he does do the Shadow Walk.
The rock. Now. Where is it? Wow. Cannot believe it. Blind Hook's not paying off here.
Bounty will walk away from that exchange.
Very nice.
That's a big pickup for them, being able to take out that Alchemist. He was worth quite a bit of gold to them at this point, as well as giving that to the Bounty Hunter as well.
Yeah, it doesn't take any gold on CM for her to hold him in place and let everybody dance around him.
And Pudge, able to deny himself off again. I think that brings his total to 3 or 4 denies. That's a lot of gold not going the way of the Radiant.
Morana's auto attacks at this point just tickle.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Some her nuke's there. Really being Oh,
with the illusion!
Green
she turned around and had to fight Mega Vengeful Spirit. Didn't pick that one up, and then Morana, of course, was in there for the cleanup. But I do appreciate that she said there could only be one and fought her illusion to the death.
There could only be one Annalinder.
Overall, pretty interesting exchange there. Probably an end to that.
Bad news.
I don't know
Middle
what
tower.
I would call
Everyone,
a long
go,
skirmish,
now.
Maybe, that we saw going on near mid lane.
A meandering battle.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
A meandering thing battle.
Meandering.
So yeah.
We will also point out our other idea for the channel. As Dota usually for us involves some sort of drinking, not necessarily heavily, but usually when we're Dotaing, there is some sort of drink in our hand. trying out the instead of Rojo Dodo, Drunken Dodo,
Alco
Dodo, bringing you guys some entertainment. Ooh, in multiple ways, and we got some information, some excitement going on mid here.
Ooh.
And a nice swap from VS. Rubik just stops for a second. Not really totally sure what happened to him, I don't think.
He's looking around. Oh, the mist coming too.
That's a two-fight.
Yeah, Tidehunter actually has gotten most of his kills in this fight from melee attacks with a big old double damage. He wally-whopped a couple of people.
I just like that word.
Oh, ooh.
Bounty putting a big hurting on Tidehunter.
It is frustrating to see a Tidehunter with no items refuse to die.
The drum's given him some nice early stats, Radiant's as well as blink for initiation, as well as the escape. Pretty survivable, I would say, for now, without having a whole lot of items to his name.
I had a tea delivery. I'm pretty good about that. Be jelly.
I don't need a tea delivery because I have Dire's scotch.
I need to bust out my third G&T.
You're drinking tea and G&T?
Whoa, you're right. Actually, that's pretty impressive.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
The caster in the making just came by and delivered this tea. We'll see. Oh, that swap. That's bad. That's bad. Okay. And just to make sure we're all in sync here. I am about 27. Got some big stuff going on mid lane here, maybe. No follow-up damage to these stuns. Oh, here it is. Big zaps. And Rubik just hooked the CM. They're really not wanting what to do with that one. Gonna be denied. Yep.
That brings his total up to 4-5 now. We do have the Bounty Hunter looking to make something happen on either the VS or the Tidehunter bottom here. Really just does not have the items to make it happen, though, especially when they're sticking pretty close together.
His experience is pretty decent. Not over the VS somehow. He is 11-5 at the moment. Which, ideally, bounty hunter, not the person that takes the kill, but in this situation, these pub games, certainly not going to judge, because you carry yourself sometimes or you don't get carried at all.
We do have that Mjolnir finished up about 30 seconds ago on Alchemist as well. Really kind of just boost up his farm even more. So he is sticking to the jungle for now. He's not looking to come out of there right now. Probably finish off another item here. This does look like he's going into a basher right now.
The experience, 15,000 now for the Dire. It's definitely looking like a big deal. Only 5,000 gold, but those two combined, they do not... They don't want to take a fight, but at the same time, because they do have the superior, they have some of the superior ganking skills. If they could get a decent Morana smoke,
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
With some coordination, it could pay off. But it would be different.
Oh, and that hook barely missing the VS from Rubick. So Bounty Hunter and Rubick, as well as CM, are going to go down there.
You just knew what was going to happen. He is really slap chopping away. Finished his basher as well, which is going to make him an insane lockdown.
He is going to drop this Quelling Blade at some point here to pick up another damage item. Maybe maybe even possibly building that basher into an abyssal beforehand. But really, I mean, looking at the EXP graph, a lot of this coming from Alchemist, looking at the 193 CS right now at 30 minutes in. I mean, not pro play, but definitely impressive, especially for a pup.
He is definitely getting his farm, and he has benefited a lot from all the team fighting bottom, where they were focused on other things, and he was allowed to get very quickly accelerated into the mid game before anyone else. But at this point, still, he has really picked his battles as far as what he wanted to engage on. Still only running around with 5, 4, and 6, where he's assisted 6 kills, and his team has taken about 29 others that he hasn't been a part of.
Really looking at his item build as well, with that acid spray combined with the AC there. Looking at Radiant's team, they don't have a lot of armor in their lineup in the first place, so that negative armor really going to play a huge part of the team fights. They're going to go down very quickly, being squishy heroes combined with the minus armor.
Oh, Pudge getting a little cheeky. I don't think he's going to be able to catch... Oh, somebody else is going to get the Rubick for him. Wall, they're back. There it is. There's the back. It's multi-actually.
Good play there by the Radiant, but just not enough damage and follow-up from those two ults to really make something happen here.
Yeah.
Oh, and that arrow on Pudge does catch him out. Wow. Track goes off. They are going to try and make something happen here on Pudge, and they will get him. Both the Janata as well as the Starfall.
Yeah, definitely some very good combos of abilities.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Tidehunter's in No Man's Land.
This is totally
if they get a decent combination
mellow
on him, it doesn't matter that he's got the health advantage. Uh-oh, CM being ganked. Oh, Shadow Blade really came. Oh, actually not the Shadow Blade, the Mirana ult. Ooh! Big crits coming off of his bounty. Deso, Battle Fury, Demon Edge.
Something kind of interesting to point out. Both teams having invis players, no detection on either side.
I have yet to see a ward.
kind of emphasis on the fact that these are pubs, but really kind of odd, even in a decent skill level pub, to see no detection coming out from either side in this.
Can't be bothered. Mirana's rushing Aghanims.
Mad dudes, middle tower, everyone, go, now!
Rubick's really dedicated to pushing this middle lane. Hopefully he's got enough backup on the way.
Yeah, and now that you mentioned that, I had not checked back in on Mirana's items for a while. I had speculated that she would not be going for the Ags with both the Ogre Club as well as the Blade of Alacrity pickup, but she did opt for that, so she's sitting on Arcane, Ags, and Yasha right now, so really kind of an odd build, not really specializing in one thing, trying to max out her casting as well as her escape mechanism and damage, so really kind of interesting to see the Aghanims pick up in this lineup. And a good hook from Pudge mid.
Yeah, good reaction with the Shadow Walk, though. He did get out of there pretty quick. Really got a fight going on here.
Tidehunter finds himself on the wrong side of the wall, but the Ravage does go off.
Mm, he's slow. I saw dust go off.
The blink does... He is able to blink out of there. Blind arrow from Run is just not going to find its target.
That would have been one for the highlight reels right there. What are you going to do?
And another good huck from Pudge. Unfortunately, he was hooking someone that was in a group of four people, so instantly finding him out and able to take him down.
Come on, guys. There's enough for me to go around.
And I am sitting at about 36 seconds right now.
36? Okay, I am now doing 37, 38, 39, so we're still fairly close.
Brief pause should catch us up here.
Wow, the MKB pickup from Bounty Hunter, he has found a lot of gold from his 15 kills. Lots of traps going off.
He is doing a very good job of taking that really odd pathing for the courier there.
That relic. But,
Bounty Hunter doing a very, very good job of getting those tracks off every time it's off cooldown and they're in your fight.
Rubik took the concoction, but that courier was coming from the secret shop with the here we go. The slap chop is in full effect. Stunning himself.
And he did opt to go for that Abyssal Blade, so just tons of damage coming off of that Alchemist right now.
It was still with 1,800 in the bank. It's absurd.
So 36 minutes, he finds himself with Midas, Phase, AC, Abyssal, as well.
I feel like if he could build himself just a BKB at this point, he could fight their whole team 1v5. Oh, so confused. Mass confusion.
That was almost like an invisible swap there. Murana going into her ulti, but still swapped during the fade time.
Oh.
So Alchemist not really sure what's going on.
Gotta
we
love.
See the concoction from Rubik.
He concocted himself and ate a concoction. Nick's really just loving the squishy support.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
Really good counter pick in that situation.
Green dude's top thing is about to get knocked
There's
over.
A lot of heroes that ruin CM's day. I gotta think in the top five Nick's as well.
Radiant structures are fortified.
We are seeing a level 4 Dagon come up on Nyx after that CM pickup. And a good hook from Pudge on the Darkseer.
And it only took two swings. Yes, I don't... I guess she escaped that one, actually, now that I think about it.
The arrow coming off from Murana to try and stop Pudge in his tracks there. She is able to get away. Bounty Hunter going to pick up the kill there.
But Alchemist showing how easy he can be the kite.
Also showing himself a bit of a honey badger. Just kind of running in here like he does not give two flying Fs. Speaking of Fs, big shout out to probably our only viewer and a good friend, good Dota, decent Dota player, very nice guy. F is probably going to be our only viewer at first, so thank you and a shout out to him. Hopefully we'll be able to rally some other people into watching our videos. And a nice arrow from Rana finishes off the BS for a triple.
I also like to point out in some replay that I do appreciate how you said F. A good, I mean decent Dota player.
Hey, but we're all actually, decent.
Yeah, not bragging on ourselves here. We work. I mean, those who can't do cast. Those who
That's
can't
true.
Cast.
That's true.
Play LOL. but yeah, definitely a good friend. One of the people actually that kind of suggested to us, hey, if you get recording software, I would love to watch you. And so we thought, one viewer, let's do it.
And thus, Rojo Dodo was born.
Wow, a Darkseer really going off
Dyer's
that wall
middle
to
tower
like
is
to catch
under
next.
Dyer's middle tower has
Amazing Alex deciding to say something. I'm not sure. XXX.
Frankly, if I was being trolled by this, I would lose my mind.
It might be kind of interesting to try and read some of this Russian as it reads by letters. Obviously, the letters have
There'd
different
be no
sounds.
Ron, Ito, Texi, Kim, Mahu,
666. XXX.
Goddamn Himmer!
And now you know why they hate each other so much.
Roshan has fallen to the Radiant.
Wow, bounty.
Bounty Hunter is following the Roshan.
With no lifesteal, no less. I mean, I'm pretty impressed by that.
And he does pick up the haste rune as well, so really low life. Now he decides to pick up the Vlads after he fights Roshan.
I've got regen. I'm going to fight Rosh.
Huh? Alchemist concocting himself. The frostbite goes off. Really just kind of keeping him.
Stay playing. Right there. I'm leaving. That's how CM ends most of her dates, I think. Dinner was nice.
See you later.
No good night kiss for you.
Rubik channeling up a concoction, trying to make something happen. You're not going to be able to find anybody at this time frame.
Throw it! Okay. I really think he could have thrown that BS. But...
Nick's going on the bounty, triggers the Aegis, and Rubik will go down as well.
Wow.
And they will pick up the bounty again after the Aegis trigger.
Oh, with that Reaver especially, looks like we're going to see a minus. At this point, you're just about so minus its usefulness. At level 25, it's pretty much been told.
And he may hold on to that until his heart is actually finished, just to get that little bit of extra gold to push him closer to his 6th slot.
Got the rest.
And then that is a level 5 Dagon coming up on next now.
Wow. Yeah, things not looking so salvageable at this point for the Radiant side. But just so much.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
The XP graph, 20,000 in favor of the Dire, and 7,500 gold in favor of the Dire, which pretty
Dire's
much you can be guaranteed is almost
attack.
All in the pockets of Alchemist.
And the kill's looking fairly close at 41 to 48, but as we learned in TI3 and multiple matches, kills mean nothing, thrones mean everything. Really, this Alchemist coming out of the jungle just as a monster after not seeing hardly any action for the first, I would say, 25 minutes of the game, being very selective in the team fights, is now just wrecking the whole field.
Oh, camera issues. Arrow, just threading the needle for everyone here.
We do see the swap from VS, and Mirana does get stunned in the middle of the leap. Trying to get out of here, the creeps blocking her up a little bit, also blocking VS, so she may be able to escape this here. The heart is picked up on Alchemist. The Frost Nova goes off. Nyx does get away from that, even though the Frost Nova, very low life when that went off on top of him.
Darkseer says, Ito.
Ito. X.
Oh. X.
And the concoction goes off and catches both Rubik and the Shadowbladed CM, so she may get caught out here if it runs out. And a blunt! The hook! Good hook from Budge, taking CM out finally.
That's a twofer! Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Punch does have the gem, so I did not realize he had the gem picked up. It was how he was able to pick up CM there.
Radiant middle tower.
Good ability on his bench when it comes to dodging those arrows.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Yeah, this push is more or less unstoppable at this point. Got it pushed in. Alchemist will never lose enough health.
With the heart and the AC, and he does pick up the BKB, so he's heading over to the secret shop to sell his Midas right now. He will be 6 slot at this point.
He could more or less walk up to the fountain to claim his BKB and just fight it from there on out, but taking the safe for Jessamers.
Still more action going on mid here. We see Nyx vendetted up looking for a kill here. Darkseer is able to back with very low health there.
Just.
And the frostbite going off on Pudge. Pudge getting low. He will go down, not able to deny himself. Carapace goes off on Nyx. He is able to stun the Bounty Hunter up. And Bounty Hunter does go down, but the CML is going to pick up Nyx and take BS very low. Able to boost herself out of there with 4 staff charge though. Again, sorry
about,
for psychic casting.
Give yourself about 2 or 3 seconds there. But you're pretty close, so it's not bad. Hey, I'm going to let you do these team fights. This seems to be working out nicely for me.
Dire's again, finding our stride as a casting team. So
yeah, I just rolled 50 seconds.
50 seconds?
I'm sorry, 50 minutes, 0 seconds.
I was going to say, I'm a ways ahead of you now. I'm rolling on 12, 13, 14. Dire's bottom
tower is under attack. Okay, you are maybe 2 seconds ahead of me still.
Darn your compression, Walsrud.
It's got to be something. It's very strange that a replay could desync like this, but we'll figure it out. It's really, we're getting better at it already, I think. The less we talk about it, the better, but we'll work around it. It's first day out. Not too worried. We got a big top lane push coming in, which has afforded the Radiant the opportunity to push up the mid. Unfortunately, three at a time, not going to cut it.
And the concoction does hit Darkseer. Alchem is picking that up very quickly. VS actually picking up the kill. That gem of True Sight providing sight for CM. CM is going to go down very quickly. Rubick most likely soon to follow.
I would just hate to use that force staff and realize your character's facing the wrong way. Oh, Rubick, please. Please, Rubick, don't do it.
Oh, and he went back on the high ground. They do have sight of him now. The VS stun goes up. And Alchemist able to quickly two-shot him, but VS still getting the kill again.
They are just way too... Oh, I knew that concoction. That was very good bait there from Mirana.
Bounty Hunter again, not paying attention to the Pudge having the Gem of True Sight. Well, actually, Pudge does not have it now. It's the Tide Hunter. No? Who has the detection? I'm so confused right now.
The gem is currently on. Nobody on. Radiant has one. Direside is on then.
VS. So VS has it.
Alright, now's the time. Pretty much just stand next to that tower and chop it. Unless you're gonna go Call of Duty. Whack, 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 whack. Oh.
And again, I just realized, may have been the Scotch talking, but Nyx did have Dust. That's how they were able to pick up the bounty under there.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Dust coming out on the bounty at 47 minutes.
And last hurrah, CM ult there, trying to throw a Feasing Field to do something. But again, that Alchemist, even being lifted into the fountain, taking those fountain shots like a champ, just cannot be brought down at this point.
No? What are you doing? Yeah, we're more or less trolling at this point. They do know they've got the beam. Last one. Oh, bounty, very
Snowbap! Picking up Tidehunter like a man, just coming out there.
Radiant's middle tower. I think those are eyes with crosses in them.
I'm not sure if those are crosses or just tears that go upward and downward because they're so distraught at this point. The Dire really just expanding the lead here, 60 to 44. Looking at the EXP and the gold graph, well over 30,000 for the EXP. Looking at about almost 20,000 for the gold, so really not going their way at this point. Pretty much GG, just has not been called yet. Something bad is happening in your bottom. There really is no split push to bring them out of this. They don't have a Nature's Prophet, they don't have Keeper of the Light to keep them pushed out of base. Really just more of a ganking and team fight lineup a little bit here, so they really don't have anything to combat this. The Alchemist, as you said before, pretty much 1v5ing their team. He will go down in base, We do see a Butterfly pick up on Vengeful Spirit, so she's going a little bit semi-carry now with the Deso as well as the...
Silly Chase.
It's the Desolator as well as the Butterfly. Boots of Travel now picked up on Alchemist. He's just going to be teleporting right back into the fight here on this creep wave. Again, a little bit of a lull here. We did mention both Walser and I are both married, so contrary to belief, popular belief, I am not 14 years old, though I sound like a 14-year-old, perhaps also look and act like it. I am not.
True facts
about my voice. Some people may be soothing, like Kenny G. Some people may find me annoying, like
some people don't find Kenny G soothing at all.
what I just said.
That's a good one. Yeah, more or less we got the typical, hey, we won this game, let's get sweet items for Dota buff kind of action going on.
I want people to think I played awesome in this game. And a very oddly misplaced stun by Nyx, just kind of throwing it out there.
He didn't like that rock.
Stupid trees.
Trees.
And the ducks here being stunned up in the trees here, just kind of chilling out here inside these trees. Didn't get saved by their mana, even though the concoction would have given them a little.
This Pudge is really hunting here.
The alchemist throwing the acid spray. They know he's in the trees somewhere. Looking on the wrong side here, though. Roshan does go down to Bounty Hunter. However, alchemist as well as Pudge are right there. He is going to Shadow Walk and run away. Blind hook from Pudge there. Not going to catch anything.
Well, as this game winds down, like we said, we'll try to continue finding relatively even pub games. This one definitely swung in the favor of... That's just cruel.
Right you there. Hate to see that kind of thing happen.
But yeah, we'll try to keep bringing these quality pub matches, some Let's Plays, and any creative ideas we come up with the community wants to see. We'll try to make this channel interesting, because we do think there's room for more commentators in the scene. You look at StarCraft and the absolute variety they've got going on. Dota, really, we think, being new to the scene still, TI3 really where Dota has hit its stride as far as public appeal. The scene's got a lot of room, so we'd like to do this, have some fun, and hopefully people like it. What you gonna do? Get
radiant structures are fortified. And again, comments, suggestions, always welcome. We're ready for the hate. We know there's going to be some of that, but any good suggestions as well. Things you like, things you don't like, things you'd like us to change. Things you like about what we do. Again, we're just trying to have fun. We both love Dota. We want to help you guys love Dota. That's what we're trying to do here, so. Let's get into it.
Wow, Alchemist does not care about the mount damage.
I called it once earlier. He's a bit of a honey badger at this point, so.
Alchemist does not care. Oh, yeah. No. Somebody, that bastard just.
He got out of there with 25 HP.
And again, Venge.
Radiant Ancient is under attack. Yes, we'll pick up another kill. Radiant Ancient is getting killed! Really looking at this team, you know, you'd expect the mid Mirana to really carry the game. However, Bounty Hunter ending the game with 20, 12, and 11, really trying to be the main carry there. Unfortunately, Alchemist, though, staying in the jungle till he had 6 slots almost, sitting in the jungle at 4 and 5, came out at the end 27 and 14. So really just kind of doing whatever he wanted to this game. They didn't stop his farm, didn't interrupt him too much in lane. He moved into the jungle and just kind of got out of control. So really, big mistake from the Radiant, not trying to interrupt him a little more. Maybe get some Mirana ulti ganks in the jungle, trying to stop him from getting that out of control. But yeah, all in all, well played by both sides, I feel.
Yeah, they did what they could with the lineups they had. Alchemist showing why, with a good pilot at the helm, why he is such a top pick right now. That gold is just insane. You can't leave him alone, or you've thrown the game early. You just don't know it yet. So I think that's it for this cast. Hopefully this one will be a clean upload, unlike our last one. And I think that's it. That's Roho Dota. This is Walrus.
This is Ninjas.
All right. See you guys on the next one.